Hello, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and a visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's That Celebrity Interview.
It is. How are you?
Having a wonderful life. How about you, Chef Kevin?
I'm doing well, thank you.
And Gary Black, did you bring your friend from the Department of Agriculture?
Commissioner Black is here.
Good morning. Well, we wish you were here. Welcome to Georgia anyway.
Thank you for joining me here in Dallas, Texas. Where are you guys? Because it's beautiful in Dallas. Where are you? And tell me about the weather.
We are in deep in the heart, as you would say back there, but we're in the heart of Idea Onion producing territory this morning. We're in Toombs County, Georgia for the start of the 2018 season of our great state vegetable.
That's so good that you told me that you're in Georgia. Commissioner, tell me a little bit about the Vidalia onions and what they mean to your state.
It's a $130 million crop here, and we're very excited about it. We've grown sweet onions for quite a long time, but we operate under a federal marketing order, much like Washington State apples, and this is a product that's produced in all or parts of 20 counties in Georgia. It's the only place on earth where you can grow a Vidalia onion and label it that. The trademark is actually owned by the State Department of Agriculture. It's our job to maintain the standards and work with growers, but also assist in the marketing as we're doing today. And we're thankful to help get the word out for 2018.
Well, I'm so glad you shared that, Commissioner Black, because I learned a lot. Let me jump over to Chef Kevin. Chef Kevin, okay. So the commissioner's got the job to make sure you get the onions. What are you doing with them?
You know, the job of any great chef is when you get in wonderful product is to not do too much. You want to emphasize its natural qualities. And so for Vidalia onions, that means emphasizing that natural sweetness that it has, that sort of low sulfur content. It is the sweetest onion that you can get, and that's what we want to showcase.
All right, then. Do you have any tips? Because I promised my audience before you came on you'd have at least one cooking tip for them with the onion.
I have so many cooking tips, but I'll limit it to only a few. First of all, remember that with a sweet onion, it's not a super hot onion. And so what you want to do is that you want to kind of emphasize that and show it off. So less is more, meaning less cooking to it. To really showcase that. The other is that when you're choosing an onion, you have to know how to pick the right ones. So we got a basket of onions here in front of us. That natural golden color on the exterior, that is quintessential to the Vidalia onion, but also checking right here at the top, that's the area where the green stalk would be. Give it just a little push, and if that's still firm, that means that onion's really fresh. Sometimes they get a little soft or a little soggy, especially if they've been in the store for too long or maybe they were last year's crop. So always check that out, and that's going to ensure your perfect freshness. It's still going to be crisp and juicy on the inside.
Go ahead. You got one more for us? Because I got one Facebook question for you.
Absolutely. So one of my favorite things to do with the Vidalia onions is just to roast them whole in their skin. And what's amazing about it is that natural golden skin will hold in all of that juice. And what you end up with is an onion that's naturally very creamy on its own. And so it makes for a wonderful soup or a puree. It makes for a wonderful sort of onion dip, almost like a French onion dip from that same process. And if you want to talk about the perfect caramelized onion, which I know everybody loves, there isn't one that's better for it than the Vidalia onion.
I love that. Now, my Facebook question is, one of the posters said they love Vidalia onions, but how should they store them? Do you know?
Commissioner, do you want to talk about that?
They're going to be in a cool, dry place. And, of course, the ancients of the industry would tell you to simply take pantyhose and put them in one at a time and tie a knot between them and keep them in a cool place. But certainly, refrigeration does help. We have controlled atmospheric storage for the growers that enable us to actually extend the life of the season. And so, as products, that's hopefully going to allow your consumers to have them on into the fall. But we're hopeful if you buy a 50-pound bag today and just tie them up, keep them where they're not touching each other, and keep them in a cool and dry place. Vidalias will store for a long time, and you'll be able to enjoy those with your family for, you know, throughout a couple of seasons.
Right, and I actually like to, when I'm storing them as well, I like this tip too. This is the bottom side. That's the part where it goes into the ground. If you actually let it sit on that side, it doesn't get bruised as much, and so it's actually a nice way. So if you only have a few of them at home and you're storing them, make sure you store them with that root side down to the ground.
All right, those are some great ideas. I want to thank you, Gary Black, Commissioner of the Department of Agriculture, and Top Chef Kevin Gillespie. Kevin, when are we going to see you on TV again?
Oh, I can't give away all my secrets, but we'll just say it's very soon. So, and other than today, you mean? Yeah.
Yeah, we are. We like seeing you in the long version. It's the quick version here.
I appreciate it.
Thank you so much. Do we have a website? I think I forgot to ask about that.
Absolutely. You can go check out VidaliaOnion.org for photos, for stories about the growers. You can, on social media, you can follow the hashtag OnlyVidalia, again, for some great photos and also some dishes that we're making. And then check out GeorgiaGrown.org. That doesn't just represent the Vidalia onions, but all the other wonderful produce that we grow in this state.
Yeah, Valder, if you go to GeorgiaGrown.com, you can learn all about nature's favorite state, and that's Georgia. We thank you for the opportunity of visiting this morning.
Well, Georgia is my second favorite state behind Texas. Texas is my number one, but Georgia is my number two. I want to thank you guys for being my guest today on the Valder Beebe Show and talking about the Vidalia onions. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, Valder. So much.